SSMSBoost improves the way values can be copied from results grid of SSMS. Let's start with the most common case. I select several IDs from customer ID column holding down CTRL key. Now when all the desired values are selected, I invoke context menu and choose Copy as SQL Values List. The data is now in clipboard, and when I paste it to SQL editor, it appears lined up and comma separated, just as you need it for building where in statement. Next case, string values. I'm gonna build a query that returns customers with particular client names. I pick several first names holding down CTRL key. Now when I used copy as SQL values list function and paste the result, you can see that SSMSBoost has built the list of quoted strings and has automatically added end prefixes for NVARCHAR values where required. This means that SSMSBoost reuses data type information from results grid and copies values in correct text representation. This feature supports the majority of SQL data types. In the last example, let's see how the DateTime values are processed. I select the desired strings, click Copy as SQL Values List, and paste the result to SQL Editor. The DateTime values are inserted in standard ISO form, that is invariant to regional settings. To beautify the resulting code, you can use our format function that applies predefined formatting styles to your SQL queries. But that is not all. If you hold down Shift button while clicking Copy as SQL Values List, you will get your copied data columned and comma separated. And if you do the same with CTRL key pressed, you will get your strings columned without any separators. The default and key dependent separators are fully customizable. You can set it according to your own needs. Click Settings button on SSMSBoost toolbar and find Grid Data Copy. Make your own adjustments to the desired templates and hit Apply and Close button. Now let's feel the difference performing the same actions using built-in copy-paste functionality of SSMS. You can see that the native copy-paste function neither converts data to its string representation nor creates a comma-separated list. That is all for today. I hope you like the tips and that they will improve your experience working with SQL Server Management Studio. If you liked our video, please hit the subscribe button and don't forget to share it with your colleagues and friends. We will also appreciate it if you share your feedback in the comments below to help us improve this functionality. Thank you for watching and we'll see you next time.